पहले बनाता कोई, यूं ही नहीं दिल लुभाता कोई। जाने तू या जाने ना, माने तू या माने ना।
ऑफ कोर्स फ्रेंड्स, whenever we watch such types of bonding or relationships between human and animal, that time we definitely believe that animals are more than human beings. So hello friends, I'm Mr. Ravindra Bhale Rao and I welcome you to my channel, that is English for Learners. Friends, today we are going to learn one of the best poems, that is Animals, written by Walt Whitman. But before watching this video, as usual, I request you, don't forget to subscribe my channel. Let's see brief introduction about poet Walt Whitman. He born in 1819 and dead 1892. Walt Whitman, a major figure in early American poetry. In an age when all poetry was rhymed and metrical, Whitman made a break with tradition and wrote a revolutionary new kind of poetry in free verse. He was a non-conformist in all respects, including his social life. The poet tells us that he feels more at home with animals than humans, what he finds complicated and false. Let's listen audio of the poem Animals. I think I could turn and live with animals. They are so placid and self-contained. I stand and look at them long and long. They do not sweat and ween about their condition. They do not lie awake in the dark and weep for their sins. They do not make me sick, discussing their duty to God. Not one is dissatisfied. Not one is demented with the mania of owning things. Not one kneels to another, nor to his kind that lived thousands of years ago. Not one is respectable or unhappy over the whole earth. So they show their relations to me and I accept them. They bring me tokens of myself. They evince them plainly in their possession. I wonder where they get those tokens. Did I pass that way huge times ago and negligently drop them? The name of the poem is Animals. Introduction. This is a reflective poem, describes the qualities of animals that human beings must have possessed in the early stage of evolution, but which we have lost. The poet indicates that we should possess these qualities in order to improve human relationships and to make this world a better place to live in. Let's see explanation in details. First two lines, I think I could turn and live with animals. They are so placid and self-contained. Difficult words are, turn means transform or change. Placid means not easily upset. Self-contained means self-sufficient. Explanation. The poet expresses, or the poet says, that the possibility that he could change his lifestyle and live with the animals. The reason he gives us is that animals are so calm and self-composed. That is, they are so placid and self-contained. That is called so calm and self-composed or self-sufficient. Next line, I stand and look at them long and long. Explanation, the poet can stand and gaze or look at them, look at those animals for long hours. Long and long means for long hours or for a. Next line, they do not sweat and whine about their condition. Difficult words are, sweat means hard work, or whine means complain. Explanation, they do not sweat means the poet has observed that they do not get sweat from too much labor or from too much hard work. Means they do not do hard work for improving their condition. Means animals do not perspire from too much labor or trying to improve their condition. And whine about their condition means they do not complain mournfully, sadly about their living condition. Next line, they do not lie awake in the dark and weep for their sins. Explanation, animals do not spend sleepless hours expressing sorrow for their misdeeds or for their sins. Next line, they do not make me sick discussing their duty to God. Difficult words, make me sick means disgust me or to make somebody feel sick. Explanation, animals do not disgust the poet by talking to him about their duty to God. Next line, not one is dissatisfied, not one is demented with the mania of owing things. Difficult words are, demented means mad, mania means crazy or craze. Mania is a mental, it is a serious mental illness, we can say. Explanation of this line is, not a single animal seems discontented or dissatisfied. They do not behave irrationally or madly pursuing the ownership of worldly goods. Next line, not one kneels to another, nor to his kind that lived thousands of years ago. Difficult words are, kneels to means worships or adores. Explanation, poet says that no animal kneels or no animal worships to another animal as a sign of worship, nor to any ancestor that lived centuries ago. Next line, not one is respectable or unhappy over the whole earth. difficult word is respectable, means too happy and satisfied. Explanation: poet says that no animal has ideals about or is unhappy with matters that relate to the world earth. Next line: so they show their relations to me and I accept them. Explanation: poet says that animals express their relationship with the poet in a simple way, and he in turn accepts them for what they are. Next line: they bring me tokens of myself, they evince them plainly in their possession. Difficult word: evince means to show. Explanation: animals offer the poet visible signs of qualities such as innocence and simplicity, and reveals to him by their behavior how these qualities quite clearly belong to them. Next line: I wonder where they get those tokens. Difficult word: tokens means virtues like innocence, simplicity, contentment, etc. Explanation: the poet wonders or surprises where the animals obtain or get those tokens or those virtues like innocence, simplicity, or contentment, these type of virtuous qualities. Last line: did I pass that way huge times ago and negligently drop them? Difficult word: negligently means carelessly. Explanation of this line is: the poet wonders or surprises if mankind, represented by the poet himself, while passing through the various stages of evolution, once possessed these qualities ages ago and then across the years carelessly gave them up. In short, we can say that in this line poet tells us that indirectly, that if we want to improve human relationships, we should observe and pick up qualities that animals now possesses and which we might have once possessed but have carelessly given up on the path of evolution or development. Friends, I wished you might have liked this video. If you liked it, please share it. If you have any suggestions for me, please write in comment box. Wish you a good day. Thank you very much.